Thank you all so much for being here. It is an important day. I do want to thank Sheriff Bianco. Your words are very inspiring, Sheriff, and National Fraternal Order of Police President Yoes for his words. And of course, our dear friends, as Steve pointed out, our colleagues here who have worn the badge, Clay Higgins and Pete Stauber and Anthony D'Esposito and Mike Ezell and others in our conference who have served in many capacities, and we're delighted that they're here now. You see behind us standing here others who have worn the badge, who have stood on that thin blue line and put their lives on the line for everybody else. And so we do this every day. We look for new ways, the House Republicans, to stand with law enforcement. We stand with the men and women in blue. We stand with all of our sheriffs and police officers, our border patrol agents, our law enforcement officers across the board in every capacity, because they are doing the hard thing. They are doing the often difficult thing. Increasingly, it is a difficult calling and vocation. Today is Peace Officers Memorial Day, of course. And so, as was mentioned earlier, we pay tribute to all those who, out of that selfless sacrifice, have paid the ultimate price. They've given their lives for our safety, and they have laid down their lives for others. And that is the greatest blessing of all. 26,000 officers have died in the line of duty, 56 in America just this year alone. And these officers exemplify the American spirit. They are the best of us, the best in every city and community. They have pledged their own lives and their sacred honor so that others may live in peace. And we honor that. And that's a biblical admonition to give honor where honor is due, especially on a week and on a day like this. And this week we pay tribute to those who do clothe themselves with that dignity and decency and who stand on the lines of justice and keep us safe. So as Leader Scalise mentioned, we'll be passing legislation on the floor to make that clear and to do everything we possibly can to celebrate those officers and to protect those who protect all of us. And oftentimes it's a thankless job, as you know, as has been mentioned today. There are many people, too many people, and often some elected officials in Washington who have given voice to this idea that we should defund the police or have anti-police legislation or policy. It's absolute madness. And we are now seeing the completely foreseeable result of that in communities around the country, with crime off the charts, violent crime rising, and all of these problems with the open border, all of it related together. And what the common denominator in all of it is a disrespect for law and order, as was mentioned earlier, for the rule of law, and that is something that we have to maintain. An FBI report just yesterday has reported that the rate of assaults on law enforcement officers in America is at a 10-year high. We have got to reverse that. As the sheriff said earlier, we've got to make crimes criminal again. It's just common sense. And I think everybody in the country who looks at this objectively understands it. Anybody who's not involved in the radical, woke, progressive left understands clearly that you got to maintain the peace. We are, this week on the House floor, will be voting, for example, other legislation to expand the concealed carry rights of qualified police officers. How many of you understand that when the good guys are armed, the bad guys do less harm, right? We're going to address anti-police attacks, protect law enforcement in the line of duty, support the mental health of those who serve as police officers, and we'll be voting to deport illegal aliens who assault law enforcement. Boy, we sure hope everybody votes for that one. This ought to be easy. This ought to be non-controversial. And we're going to make sure that everybody sees where all of us in the House stand. Our law enforcement officers keep us safe. They put their lives on the line to do it, and we are forever indebted. And these gestures and these pieces of legislation that we passed this week is the very least that we can do to support them. With that, we'll take a few questions. Front row.